I was a member of a fraternity brother at Phi Gamma Delta, which was a great house. And so all of the social aspects of it, the fraternity aspects of it, and the academic, it was a wonderful 4 years. In 1957, when I was about to graduate from University of Rhode Island, it was obviously a very exciting time. I was about to become engaged to my high school girlfriend, and I had made the decision to go on to graduate school. Before the end of the first year, I realized that physics research was probably not something I wanted to do, and so I was looking around to see what was available, and I decided to leave school and go into industry. One company I interviewed, which was called Transitron Electronics, was in the semiconductor business. And I knew enough at the time to realize that that was had the potential to be a very, very strong industry, although it was in its infancy. So between 1968 and 1975, we lived 5 years out of the country. We lived in Hong Kong, we lived in Munich, and we lived in Singapore, and it was really a great experience. The kids, our youngest son started first grade in Hong Kong. He did second, third grade in Munich, fourth and fifth in California, and sixth and seventh back in Singapore. But in the back of my mind, I had always had the goal to run my own company. And I left National with three other individuals who were very, very strong engineering people, and we started a company. We started a company called Sierra Semiconductor, and we got our first venture capital funding in 1984, January, as I recall. From a career point of view, it's very clear. Find work that you absolutely love. And if you love it, then go work very hard at it. And how you'll know that is if, and it's the way I felt for years, every morning when you get up, if you cannot wait to get to the job, then you know you're in the right job.